Right when we thought that we could hope for new MacBooks sometime during this summer, we are getting some new rumors that maybe we should not keep those hopes too high, cause it may happen later. Is this good or bad news? Let's see. Hi friends, and welcome to Digital Mocking channel. My name is Marco, this is your dose of Apple news, leaked information, rumors and opinions. Make sure you subscribe, leave a comment below, hit the like button, and don't forget to enable all notifications so you don't miss the next video. I do want to say thanks to everyone that participated in Digital Mocking's raffle, and obviously to congratulate 15 Hearts for winning MOFT Snap Tablet Stand giveaway. Stay tuned for more. If you want to make individual list of disappointments from the last WWDC, on top of the list would likely be 16-inch and 14-inch Macs. While it was once again proven, especially lately, that you should not rely on alleged leaks and speculations, Mark Gurman from Bloomberg, on the other hand, was usually quite reliable. In his previous report, he did say that we may see new MacBooks at one point during the summer. However, one of the common tipsters on Twitter, Dylan DTK, has posted how new MacBook Pro models are likely coming in quarter 4 this year, late October or early November to be precise. Alongside these new MacBooks, according to him, we should see new Mac Mini, and this is not the first time we hear this. And as he specified a few weeks ago, with the improved version of the M1 processor, so-called M1X, which will power all three devices, as well as still rarely mentioned next edition of the bigger iMac, or just iMac Pro, I guess. Well, personally, I find Gurman's article more trustworthy. We should be fair and clarify once again that he did say as soon as this summer, which does not imply 100% certainty. So we cannot claim that this could be considered as a delay, although issues with chips and everything that has been happening could prove that something like that has occurred. Blackbeard Hosting. Simple, easy to use website installer, 24/7 customer support, real people, and more. Hosted on fast, reliable, and secure servers. Check it out. 1 month free trial, no credit card needed. With Digital Mocking's code, you get 5% off. Blackbeard Hosting. Hosting as it should be. As far as the specs goes, we don't have any new information beside what we've learned from Gurman, or maybe something similar. New 10-core chips with 8 performance and 2 power efficient ones, with option to choose between 16 and 32 GPU ones. These new processors will allow more Thunderbolt connections, as well as option to upgrade up to 64 gigs of unified system memory, which is huge increase comparable to the original M1 16 gigs maximum. Some sources are suggesting that Apple and TSMC are already preparing for 4 or even 3 nanometer switch, but that can likely take place next year or year after. These new MacBooks will showcase slight redesign, more flat edges, removal of the touch bar, possibly 3 Thunderbolt ports, return of the iconic MagSafe connector, and micro SD card slot. Amazing. While initial predictions, including the ones of Ming-Chi Kuo, were pointing at use of mini LED for those updated MacBook Pro designs, few websites like Digitalna have published some opposing information, which eventually has been corrected afterwards. Mac Mini, on the other hand, is expected to arrive in smaller form factor, much similar to Apple TV and with few I/O changes. Mark Gurman has seemed more hesitant about its release and even mentioned possible delay of this mini desktop. Now, what do you think? Third quarter or fourth? When we will see new MacBook Pro models? Please answer in the comment section below. Make sure you subscribe, hit the thumbs up, and turn on notifications. Don't forget to check the links in the description. Beside offers and discounts, you may find some Apple products and accessories there as well. Thank you so much for watching the Digital Mocking channel. My name is Marco. Talk to you soon. Have an excellent day. Bye.